Hello everyone! Today I'm going to show you how to make icy caviar from liquid nitrogen, which you can use to surprise even most choosy guests at the dining table. I think some of you already know that liquid nitrogen can be used not only for entertainment and chemistry shows, but it is also used in the modern molecular gastronomy. For instance, you can use it to make quickest ice cream. It takes just a minute to make. Such an ice cream has an insanely smooth texture because of the incredibly small ice crystals the product is made of, which is a result of the quick freezing of the ice cream mixture. For instance, in the USA, there is a cafe chain where they serve ice cream made only from liquid nitrogen, and these cafes are extremely popular among customers. However, such a treat is quite costly because the cost of the ready product is much more expensive than regular ice cream. It is due to the fact that liquid nitrogen is quite expensive. In 1899, after experimenting with liquid nitrogen, Carl Jones invented a brand new kind of ice cream called dipping dots. So, let us not dwell on the boring history. Let me better show you how it is made. To make such an unusual ice cream, you need to prepare 200 ml of 10% whipped cream, 200 ml of 35% whipped cream, and a can of condensed milk. Since all the regular condensed milk has been sold out, I had no choice but to buy chocolate condensed milk. It is going to work too. First, I'm mixing both whipped creams. To make it sweeter, I'm adding 100 grams of chocolate condensed milk. After giving the mixture a quick stir, everything is almost ready. I've got an ice cream mixture. We just need to freeze it and make a small balls from it. I'm pouring the ice cream mixture into the separatory funnel, which is attached to the retort stand. I think you have guessed that I'm going to use liquid nitrogen to freeze that ice cream. This food storage container is going to work perfectly as a container for nitrogen in this experiment. Now to make the icy caviar, I'm loosening the top of the separatory funnel at a time into the boiling nitrogen. Since the boiling temperature of liquid nitrogen is minus 196 degrees Celsius, the drops immediately cover in a layer of ice, which is why they keep their round shape, which makes them look like caviar. This is how small ice cream balls are made. After cooling to the temperature of liquid nitrogen, the balls sink down to the bottom because their density is higher than the density of liquid nitrogen. By adjusting the speed and number of drops, you can get a practically perfect product. If drops fall down too quickly, they won't have enough time to freeze and will be sticky, and the quality of the product won't be great. Nowadays you can buy such ice cream in the USA and in some European countries. Such ice cream is quite expensive. About half an hour later, container with the ice cream is almost full of such caviar. Now I think we can pour out the remaining nitrogen into the container and pour the caviar into another container. Under regular conditions, in a refrigerator, such icy caviar can be stored up to a week. After that, caviar will become sticky because of recrystallization of ice. In order to prolong shelf life of such ice cream, we need a refrigerator which can freeze to minus 40 degrees Celsius. If you live in the North Polar regions, I think you will not need a refrigerator. You can just store such ice cream outside. Thus, you can make icy caviar from different kinds of ice cream. You can make it even from fat-free ice cream, and you'll get a sorbet. After making ice cream, you need to store it in the freezer for about 2 hours in order for it to heat up. It cannot be eaten after being mixed with liquid nitrogen right away, because this very cold temperature can easily give you a frostbite. This ice cream has a very interesting texture. At first, it feels lots of small icy balls, and a second later, they start melting and giving off their flavor. Regular ice cream melts in the mouth too fast, whereas such icy caviar is quite different. However, this is not all. To surprise my friends, I decided to make such an interesting dessert from 4 types of ice cream. I am missing only one component, which is frozen foam. To make it, I need such a culinary siphon. Cooks use it for making whipped cream. I'm filling it with the same ice cream mixture I had made before. Then I'm adding the most important component, nitrous oxide. If you even played Need for Speed, then this must sound familiar. For culinary purposes, nitrous oxide is sold in such 70 atmospheric pressure pots. When it is attached to the siphon, it immediately evaporates and also partly dissolves in the milk fats, which is also present in whipped cream. Giving the mixture a shake helps nitrous oxide to better dissolve in the ice cream. Now I'm opening the valve and foamy ice cream is coming out, because when pressure is changed, nitrous oxide starts expanding, giving the ice cream a foamy texture. If you ever bought cans with whipped cream, then you know how it works and what is happening to the siphon. The only difference is that in shops cans are not refillable and they cannot be refilled with whipped cream. Such a foamy mess can be eaten on its own, but it tastes better after being frozen in liquid nitrogen. Of course, I'm not a chef and only managed to make such a circles from frozen foam. They freeze quickly in about 30 seconds. After that, such ice cream needs to heat up. If you eat it right away, you're likely to get frostbite, because its temperature is minus 160 degrees Celsius. Such a dessert is more suitable for storing than icy caviar, because it doesn't become sticky and change its texture. Now is the time for cooking the most unusual dessert. First, I'm putting a small piece of regular chocolate ice cream into a glass. Then I'm adding some whipped cream. Now I'm adding the circle from frozen foam. In the end, I'm topping it all off with icy caviar and a drop of condensed milk as an adornment. I think no one has had such an unusual dessert. So, if you want to surprise most choosy guests, I recommend that you cook such a dessert. So, if you like the edition about food chemistry, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to see many more new and interesting videos.